All right, here we are. We're doing the puck handling training intensive outdoors again. So our main focus today is going to be on doing a lot of the drills within stationary stances. And you know, that's normally the first thing that we always start with is the stationary stick handling. And then we'll do it in motion. And then we'll progress to doing it in motion, but at top speed, as fast as we possibly can. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to talk about when we stick handle is our top hand. So our top hand is our control hand. That's the hand that controls the puck. Whenever you grab your hockey stick, it's very, very important that when you grab it, you grab it with your thumb pointing down. So for me right now, if I rest my blade down, right down the middle, it's not resting on the backhand, it's not resting on the forehand, but it's right down the middle. So if you look at my thumb should always be pointing down. If it's pointing down, then you know that you've got all your fingers wrapped around the shaft, wrapped around the knob, and so you'll have a nice strong grip. If there's a lot of players that I see, they have their thumb turned to the side. So if their thumb is turning to the side, you'll notice that it's almost like you're a Ninja Turtle where you're only gripping it with a thumb and two fingers. So these two fingers are almost useless. So we need a strong grip, so make sure that thumb is pointing down. Once it points down, then you've got your grip and you can rotate your wrist as much as you want. Your grip should be tight, but your wrist should be nice and loose. Once you have that grip, again, it could be nice and free. For the puck, when we stick handle, we want to make sure that when I have the puck on the backhand side, I rotate my wrist so that it's on the backhand side, and I cup the puck. So just imagine as if I tell the kids all the lights are burning the puck, so you want to put some shade over top of it. So put some shade on the backhand side, and then when you flip to the forehand side, rotate your wrist, cup the puck on the forehand side. Another reason why we would do this is if you notice right now, my entire blade is on the ice right now. And if I didn't curl my wrist over, then look at how much my blade isn't on the ice. If it's not curled over, there's quite a bit that isn't. So it's almost like you're stick handling. If you don't curl your wrist over, it's almost like you're stick handling with a blade only this big, this small, I should say, in comparison to one that's nice and big. So the reason why, one of the main reasons why we wrap our wrist over is we want a good strong grip as well too. So if I was going to grab a baseball, I wouldn't grab it with a sort of an open fist like this. I'd wrap my fingers around it. So in the same way, you don't have any fingers on your blade, but when we lower it, we wrap our wrist over on the backhand side or wrap it over on the forehand side, almost as if we've got a good strong grip. So for our bottom hand is our speed hand. So this is our supporting hand. Top hand controls the puck. We can control the puck with our top hand, even with just one hand in our stick. But with bottom hand, I always tell the kids, if this is as fast as I can go with one hand, this is as fast as I can go with two. So our second hand adds a bit of support, and it also adds some speed as well too. Just keep in mind, your bottom hand should not be the one that's rotating. Notice my top hand, that's the one that rotates, and my bottom hand more or less just comes along for the ride. So watch how my top hand is still doing all the rotation, my bottom hand just comes along for the ride. This is not your primary hand, this is your top hand is your primary hand, and your bottom hand just comes along for that support. Third stage in stick handling, stationary stick handling, is we want to use our legs as well too. If I place the puck on my backhand side and I place my weight on my right leg, all I need to do, if I shift my weight to my left side, watch how I can actually move the puck. I haven't done anything. All I've literally done is shifted my weight from my right to my left, and I was able to move the puck. So imagine if you use your hands, you use your top hand for control, you use your bottom hand for speed, plus you use your legs. So our legs are used in both, in two ways. One, you can kind of just sort of bounce, get a bit of a step into each. When the puck is on the backhand side, I place my weight on my right leg. When the puck's on my forehand side, I place my weight on my left. You get a bit of a bounce going. Another way to do it is actually sliding. So if you slide from on your inside edges and stop on either side, that's another good way of doing it as well too. Just keep in mind that your feet should be right beside each other. So when you stop on your left foot, you can lift up your heel and just sort of drag that toe, but keep your legs nice and long. So drag it. It's just a good way to transfer your weight and use your and move the puck at the same time. One important aspect of that is when the puck is on my forehand side, then obviously my weight's regularly on my left side. Everything's down the middle, the puck, my chin, my knee, my toe, everything's in line. And when I bring it to the backhand side, same thing, weight always goes. Our upper body always needs to be coordinated with our lower body, so don't bring the puck and then your legs, or the legs and the puck, but they go at the same time, same time. And then the last way of doing it is you can just move your feet as fast as you possibly can, and your arms don't need to be coordinated with your hands. You just do it as quickly as you possibly can. So last stage in stationary stick handling is that we want to make sure that our head's up. So I always talk about peripheral vision, using your peripheral vision. I can look straight at the camera, and in the corner of my eye, I can see that the puck is down here. So in that exact same way as your stick handling, that's the type of vision that you want to use. So as I'm stick handling, I can see my puck down here. So that's the vision that we want to use. A lot of kids get used to watching the puck. And that's fine maybe for the fundamentals. So you can tell them, you know, through the stages, they can have one-handed top hand, two-handed bottom hand, get their legs moving, and then after that point, get their head up. So the reminder is that their head is up so they can see where they're going. Right now, with my head down, I can see just as much as what's within my space that I'm showing with my stick. As soon as I get my head up, now I can see the entire ice. Okay, so when we did the bounce to the step and we used our weight transfer to move the puck, last time when we were doing it stationary, we just did it with stops on our blades. This time we're actually going to do it with C-cuts. So every time that the puck goes to my backhand side, the weight's going to go onto my right leg, and I'll do a C-cut. So in the exact same way, head up, chest up, knees bent. The puck really likes it when you get close to it. So Marty St. Louis, Patrick Kane, really good stick handlers, they will sit wide, and they'll sit nice and low, chest up. And the technique is the exact same as what we talked about from stationary to in motion. Okay, so next one is the exact same thing that we did before, stick handling, but now we're doing it backwards. Same thing, weight should go nice and smoothly from left to right, and you're just doing C cuts for now. Alright, last time we did it in tight, which just meant that we were stick handling between the width of our feet. This time we're going to go forwards, and we're going to do it nice and wide. So it should be past your right foot and past your left foot, at least that wide. For this one, keep your bottom hand exactly where it is. We'll talk about later getting a full extension after if you actually slide your hand down your shaft. For now, let's just keep it just above the halfway point of the blade. Okay, next one, we're still gonna reach out wide, only now we're not gonna keep our hand in the same spot. Now we're gonna actually slide it up and down our shaft. When the puck is really wide, if I want to just keep it where it is, this is as wide as I can get if I stand up quite straight. If I bend my knees quite low, I can reach even wider. And if I bring my hands together, then I can reach even wider than that. So it's a really useful tool when we get down really low and we slide our hands together. On the forehand side, your hands should be together, reach as far as you can. And then as the puck comes to the midpoint of your body, you should slide your hand down. And then as it goes to the backhand side, you slide your hands back together. So apart, together, apart, together, apart, together. When I slide, I actually slide my hand almost all the way down the entire shaft to the blade. And it should be a smooth motion where it goes up and down the shaft. Okay, so that's actually called, that's called a tuck, when you let go of the puck and the blade. So a drag, or a toe drag, is when they stay together. And a tuck is when you actually snap them apart and the puck meets you where your blade finishes. So watch how I pull this elbow in really, really fast. And at the same time, I slide this hand down as fast as I can. So I almost let go of the puck and then meet it again on the backhand side. I do the exact same thing where I slide, bend this elbow in, and slide that hand down, and do it all within one motion. The faster you can do it, the faster that puck will slide from one side of your body to the next. Okay, so next one, we're gonna work on stick handling three times to the left, three times to the right, just so we can get used to stick handling on all parts of our body, all sides of our body. Our toes are always facing forward, we're still staying nice and wide. Stick handle three times on your left side, and then pull it across to the backhand side. Keep your toes facing forward, don't turn them towards the puck, and then stick handle three times on the right-hand side. So three times to the backhand side, three times to the forehand side, pull it across back to the backhand side, three times. Okay, so next one is the exact same thing that we did before. Three times to the right, three times to the left. Only now we're gonna be on one foot. So when you're on one foot, kick the other leg behind you. Keep your knee bent that you're on. Keep even that leg bent. And stick handle three times to the left, three times to the left. Okay, so next one's very similar to what we did before. Three times stick handling on the right side, three times stick handling on the left. Only in between, you should do a crossover. So do three stick handles on the right hand side, do a crossover, and then three times on the left. Do the crossover, focus on just dragging your toes after the crossover. So cross and just drag that last toe. When we pulled it from forehand to backhand side, we just pulled it straight across without any stick handling, and then we did three stick handles on the right. This time I want non-stop stick handling. So do your stick handles, cross over, and then do it in between. Okay, next one we're going to progress to one crossover each way going forwards. We'll just alternate between forehand and backhand side, like this. Exact same thing. We're going to do three crossovers each way, three on the right, three on the left, and we'll do it with non-stop, really quick and tight sticking. Like this. Okay, so next one, just a very basic backhand pull as you're skating backwards. Make sure when you're doing this, if I'm heading in this direction, I always rotate my wrist over so the entire blade is nice and flat on the backhand side. With my bottom hand, I actually flex my stick. So as you're skating, your stick should be making that sound. Just like this. Okay, next one's the exact same thing, but now we're going on our forehand side. So still skating backwards. I rotate my wrists over. Keep your hand nice and low on the shaft. Don't slide them together. And also, as a lefty, you want to keep the puck quite close to your right foot. So when I fold my hands over, it's nice and close. A lot of players do this where it's quite far away. And other times is they just have the toe on the ice. It's almost as if they're picking at it. So you want to make sure that once you fold your wrists over, the whole blade should be nice and flat. And again, you're making that sound as you drag it back. Okay, next one, we're gonna be still skating backwards, only now we're gonna add some backwards crossovers in. As a lefty, when I cross over on my right leg, the puck will be placed on my backhand side, and you do it the exact same way as what we did before when you're just dragging it back doing C-cuts. When I switch to left leg crossovers, skating backwards, I'm gonna alternate and bring it to my forehand side and do the exact same thing. You might need to not need to fold your hands over as much as what you did when you were just doing C-cuts, but still fold your hands over nevertheless. So check it out. We're going to do three backwards crossovers each way now, and same thing as I'm crossing over on my left leg. As a lefty, the puck is going to be placed on my forehand side, but I want to do non-stop stick handling as well. Begin the series on toe drags. Toe drags are simply here's your heel, here's your toe, just like your foot. We're just going to be dragging the puck back towards your body and doing it starting from the toe. The most important thing is, even if you do this with one hand, you should be able to flex your stick. So here's what the toe drag with one hand would look like. A toe drag simply means that, again, you're dragging it from the toe of the blade into the full blade. And it's all about how you snap and rotate your top hand and rotate your wrist over. As you're doing that, listen to that sound. I'm still able to sweep it even with just one hand. And when I place it down, same thing, you should be making that sound. We want the puck and the blade to stay attached. Even when we do basic stick handling, a good stick handler always has that puck nice and attached. So right now the puck is detached and separated from the blade, and that's not very good stick handling. You want them nice and close. Even as you come over the top and switch it to the backhand side, you want to keep the blade and the puck almost attached, or look like they're attached. Same thing goes for the toe drag. Keep them attached the entire time, so even with just one hand. As if I'm in the middle of a clock, in front of my toes where my belly button is pointing, that's 12 o'clock, here's my 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 9 o'clock. I'm gonna reach from 12 o'clock and snap it into my feet. So if you can, we'll get it right in front of our feet or in between your legs. But just with one hand, you should start in front of your body, reached, and then watch how my arm finishes out to the side. Just as if we're stick handling from forehand to backhand, basic stick handling. Our bottom hand is used as our support hand and as one that will add some speed as well. Top hand is a control hand. Top hand controls the puck and controls the movement. Bottom hand just comes along for the ride. So same thing that we were doing before with one hand, only now we're doing it with two. Next one's called snap toe drag. So snap toe drags, we're just doing the exact same motion that we did before, snapping and dragging it in really quickly, only now we're also gonna get it out also very quickly. So top hand should be rotating very fast, bottom hand should also be rotating fast. Don't be afraid to get your heel right up in the air. So sometimes some players will only bring it to here. I want you to bring it nice and high, almost vertical. So here's what it would look like and here's what it sounds like. Next one, we're gonna be doing the exact same snap toe drag, only now we're gonna do it with a rotation, so hip rotation. As a lefty, I'm going to spin to my left, almost as if I'm trying to protect the puck away from someone. Just make sure you don't snap the toe drag, then turn your hips, or turn your hips, then toe drag. They happen at the exact same time, just like most other things, so check it out. With that one, the main focus is as you snap the puck in, you're turning your hips at the same time. To make one full 360 degree turn, I always tell the kids at least do three toe drags. So this is not really what we want to do, just sort of tapping the puck. You want to make sure that the puck is actually traveling some distance. So I always tell them the length of your stick is a good length for the puck to travel. So when I snap this toe in, or the puck in, I pull it at least the length of my hockey stick and then turn my hips at the same time, almost as if I'm making a triangle around my body. I do another one, and then you're almost back to the same spot. One, two, three, to do a full 360. Next one we're gonna be doing is just a basic toe drag from 12 o'clock again, so right in front of your belly button, right in front of your toes. When you snap the puck in this time though, we're gonna be transferring our weight with our legs. So when the puck is in front of you, as a lefty, I place my weight on my left leg, and as I toe drag it in, watch how I place my weight on my right foot. So if I was gonna toe drag it in, we like the puck that it's when it's nice and close underneath our body, because that's where it's well protected away from poke checks. If I don't move my left leg out of the way, then that's as close as I can get it to the inside of my body. But if I do this, pick up my left leg, I can almost get it half a foot a little bit deeper. So my weight's on my left, as I snap the puck in, Weight goes to the right, weight goes to the left, weight goes to the right. Okay, so next one, we're just gonna do basic toe drags, snap toe drags from 12 o'clock, so from in front of your body, only now we're gonna do it in motion. Most times a common error that I see from kids is they do a lot of these where it's just little taps, and we actually wanna move the puck from forehand, from toe to the flat blade. The best part about that one, a lot of the time when I'm just as I'm demonstrating it, I notice that my head can be up. So we go by feel. So the puck, in the same way when you grab a baseball or anything with your hands, you can feel it in your hands, right? You don't need to wind up and throw it. And as you're winding up, look at your puck or whatever's in your hand. You can feel it, right? So in the same way, just doing those snap toe drags, see if you can get your head up and just go by feel. Next one, we're doing those same snap toe drags, and we're doing that with the body, the hip rotation, just as we did it before, only now we're gonna do it in motion. Check it out. Series on forehand side toe drags. Last time we were reaching where our toes were pointing at 12 o'clock. So with that one, we started in front and we finished with our arm out to the side. This time, as a lefty, I start with the puck on the left-hand side. Toes are still facing forward. I start with the toe drag, and now this time my arm finishes actually in front of my body. Okay, so now we're just gonna progress to two hands. Just as usual, top hand does all the control and controls the puck. Bottom hand's gonna come along for the ride and add a little bit of support. Top hand snaps in, bottom hand adds support. Okay, so with that one, we want to make sure that as we're toe dragging it in, it always finishes behind our body. So as if I was wearing a pair of jeans and this the puck was my wallet, I want to place it into a spot where I know it's well protected. So as you snap it in, place it into your back pocket of the forehand side. So now we're going to do snap toe drags, but now we're going to do it from the forehand side. So same thing that we were doing before, toe drags, but now with a snap. Same way we're doing toe drags with weight transfer from noon, from 12 o'clock. Now we're gonna do it from 9 o'clock as a lefty, or as a righty, you would do it from 3 o'clock. Your toes are always facing forwards. As the puck is out, I place my weight on my left foot. As I snap the puck in, I'm gonna place the weight on my right and watch what I do with my left skate. I'll just sort of drag it, pull it behind me. If I didn't move my foot, I'd only be pulling the puck to here. But if I did move my puck, then I can almost move it into underneath my skates. So like it's almost an extra half of a foot to a full foot of protection. So check it out. So next one, we're doing the exact same body weight transfer, only this time we're gonna add it with a slide of the hand so that we can get an extra full extension. Hands come together when you reach out, and then hands slide apart as you slide it in. So hands slide apart as you pull the puck into your body. So last toe drag in the series. As a lefty, normally I'd be pulling it from the side from 9 o'clock. This time I'm gonna pull it from 3 o'clock and keep it always on the forehand side. Toes are always facing forwards. I reach out to 3 o'clock and then snap the puck. Okay, so next one is one-handed backhand toe drag. So it's gonna look like this, where I'm just pulling it from one hand, from the front of my body to behind me. It's really important that we get the whole body engaged in this drill. It's using your hips and you're using your arms and using your just flexing your stick as well is really important. So when it's on your toe of the blade, you can still flex your stick. So listen to this sound. I can still sweep it. Once I place it down, I still make that sound. So just with one hand, you can get a good strong grip on the ice so that you can move the puck quite easily. But again, we want to place the puck as far as we can in front of us and then as far as we can behind us. So if you can get it from 12 o'clock to 6 o'clock, that's the ideal toe drag. Once you get it back here, flex your stick and then pull it back in front of your body. Most important thing is that your toes are always facing forwards when you're doing it stationary. The next set of progression is actually helping to move. You can move the puck a lot easier if you rotate your hips along with it. So it would look like this. You want to make sure that you're turning your whole upper body as well. So your whole torso should be turning with it. Really most important thing is that you're not pulling it just to about here, but you're getting it all the way into your back pocket so that it's behind your body and then pulling it back in front. The advanced toe drags and advanced puck handling moves now. This one's called Brett Morgan toe drags. So all we're going to do is make the letter L in the ice. So you're going to do a toe drag, pull it from forehand to the backhand side and then back. So it looks like the letter L. You toe drag it in, slide it across, slide it back, and then back up to the toe drag. Most important part of this drill is engaging your legs and making sure that you've got some weight transfer into it. And also trying to make it into a really smooth motion. So you're toe dragging it, placing it from backhand to forehand side quite quickly. So watch my feet, watch my toes. As I do the toe drag as a lefty, my weight is on my left leg, and then I toe drag it in. I place my weight to my right leg, back to my left leg, bust out the toe drag, and then pull it back to the right. So as the puck is on the left side of your body, you've got your weight on your left. As the puck gets pulled to the backhand side, you've got your weight on your right, and obviously vice versa as a righty. We'll do the exact same thing, only now we're going to do the Brett Morgan toe drags with L toe drags, but now we're going to do it in motion. So we're going to do another long L toe drags again, so very similar to the Brett Morgan ones, only now we're going to do the L in the opposite direction. You can do this with a slide of the hand if you want to reach, or you can keep your hand right where it is, right down the middle of the shaft, but you toe drag it in from 12 o'clock and then pull it to your forehand side, so mine would be 9 o'clock. And then same thing from the front to the side. Watch my feet, how I transfer my weight from my right to my left as I toe drag the puck. Okay, so the next one, we'll get into a little bit of a fancier move, and for some fun, we're going to slide the puck between the legs. We'll do a toe drag to get the puck into our back pocket. Right now, my puck has a clear sight to my right leg inside edge. I'm going to really forcefully bend this elbow in. At the same time that I do that, I slide my hand down to the bottom of my shaft. I let the puck go. I kick it up off my inside edge, and then I repeat. So we have three motions when we do this drill. The first motion is the toe drag. The second motion is a tuck. So you're going to let go of the puck, tuck it. And then the third motion is the kick off the inside edge. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then just see how fast you can do that. One common error is that the puck doesn't get toe dragged far enough back in the first motion. You want to make sure that you pull it all the way back and your toes are always facing forwards. So your puck again has clear sight of seeing that foot that it needs to be kicked off. So now last time we did that forehand toe drag and then slide it through off the forehand side from the forehand back pocket. This time we're doing it from the backhand side. So in the same way that we were doing one-handed toe drags in the backhand side, we're doing that exact same thing. Pull it into the back pocket and then tuck it through the legs and it's now coming off of your other skate. Most important thing is that once you get it into your back pocket, more or less just sort of shimmying the puck really up, but as long as you're flexing your stick and making a bit of a sweeping sound, it'll be very easy for you to build some momentum and then snap that puck through. Okay, so next one's gonna be backhand toe drags. When we do a backhand toe drag, more times than not, we're snapping it from our forehand side to our backhand side. A lot of players will actually just pull the puck right over top of the your blade over top of the puck. But instead, I actually like to get my hands in front of the puck, push them out, and then just with the toe, give it a bit of a tap, and then slide it over. So right from here, quick little tap. Get your arms away from your body, tap it with the very tip, and then straight across your body. It should come straight across your body and stay really, really close to your right skate. So as a lefty, I pull from the left side of my body and try to keep it nice and close to my right skate. The next step is always to do it in motion now. So when we do it in motion, we want to get on a nice wide stance, keep your knees bent, and we'll do it with C cuts. I like lifting up this toe for every time that I snap that puck in. I lift up that toe and actually rotate my hips as well with the motion of snapping it over. Okay, so next step is another advanced way to stick handle. It's just to getting really used to doing toe drags on the forehand side and the backhand side. So we're gonna do a toe drag on the forehand side, but from our backhand. So from 3 o'clock, you're gonna toe drag it in, and then pull it to the backhand side and do a backhand toe drag. So in the same way you just basically stick handle, transferring your weight from backhand to forehand side. Now you're doing the same thing, but just with toe drags. So backhand side, forehand side. Same thing we're gonna do, but now we're gonna do it in motion now. So backhand side, forehand side, same thing in motion. C cuts, stay nice and wide. Okay, we got two back pocket ones. These are some of my favorite ones to do for stick handling. We're gonna do a tuck on the forehand side. I'm gonna place the puck at about 10 o'clock as a lefty, and in one motion I'm going to stop off my left skate and slide my hand down the shaft and almost kick my right leg out of the way and beat the puck with one hand on the backhand side. So just in one motion, you're letting the puck go, reaching on the forehand side, showing the puck to the player, and then kicking it out, pulling it to the backhand side just in one motion. So one drill that I use just as like a main focus on the toe drag of that last drill is you want to slide your hand down as fast as you can, and you want to bend this elbow in really quick, and then you want to meet the puck on the backhand side. And if you happen to miss it, stay close to the boards, because if you miss it, at least you've got the boards there and it doesn't fly down the ice. But you should be sliding this puck as fast as you possibly can, pull it back, and then see if you can catch it on the backhand side. When I slide the hand down, I always slide it down almost all the way down to the blade. So it's one really smooth motion where you bend this elbow in, slide that hand down, and I get it almost all the way down to the blade, and then let it go, catch it on the backhand side from there. Next one we're gonna do on the backhand side now. So I see some really good players protecting the puck really well. If there was ever a player in front of me and they wanted to poke check it, and I wanted to step from the left side to the right side, I could pull one of those toe drags on the forehand side and then step around them that way. If I ever wanted to go the other way on the backhand side, I would do the same thing. I'd pull it on the right side of my body on the backhand side and then pull it in as close as I could to my, as close as I can to my left skate, and then scoop it around. So in one motion, it should be a stop on the right foot and pulling it from backhand right to foot. So in one motion, you're pulling it forward and then way back into your left skate where it's well protected. All right, so for one of the fancier moves, we're gonna be rotating the puck on the forehand side and rotating it on the backhand side. But it starts in the heel, you slide your hands down to the toe, and then slide it back up on the backhand side from toe to heel. So you wanna make that puck spin, and you can actually get this thing going pretty fast. Okay. All right, so main focus is just using your arms. Your bottom hand should be directing it. That top hand actually just comes along for the ride. So bottom hand is actually doing most of the work, mainly just because you don't need to rotate your wrist at all on your forehand side. Just grip your stick actually quite tight on the bottom hand and just let your bottom hand rotate counterclockwise as a lefty. So again, that drill is just mostly for just placing it so you can feel the puck on from the heel right to the toe on the forehand side and from the toe right to the heel on the backhand side, just mostly for feel. Next one's a bit of a fun one. We're gonna be flipping the puck up when we flip it up and just sort of catch it, and again, just sort of play with it. Just mostly for, whenever you want. A lot of the players these days are snapping pucks, lifting it up, and bringing it up and over defensemen's hockey sticks on both the forehand and backhand side. So we'll show you how to do it on the forehand side to start. When we do it on the forehand side, start with it in front of your body. Top hand is gonna bend in as, just as you would do a toe drag. Bottom hand slides down. Rotate your top hand wrist, and then you should bring your blade nice and close to the ice. And the only thing that's actually gonna be touching the ice is the very tip of the toe, so very tip. And that's where the puck is gonna snap up on. You wanna make sure that your blade's nice and flat, just so it has a bit of a ramp that it can climb up on. But it has to be all done in one motion. So slide that bottom hand down and snap it up. Most important thing is we slide that bottom hand and then rotate our wrist, keep it nice and flat so it's nice and easy to catch. Another important aspect of the drill is in order to flip it up and keep it close to you, you want to almost uppercut yourself with your bottom hand right into your face. You don't want to pull it out. If you pull it out, it's going to be flipped up and down the ice. So make sure as you pull it in, I place my weight from my left onto my right, and then I almost bounce away from the puck and then flip it up. And then from there, again, you can catch it, play with it, and do what you like with it. In the same way we did the flip up on the forehand side, we're now doing the same thing on the backhand side. I place my weight on my right foot and give the puck a bit of a ramp. And then, again, it's just a little tap where you can get it up and over perhaps like a blade or a stick in front of the in front of you, as if you're just trying to step around a defenseman. But a lot of it's about the weight transfer. And a lot of it is about snapping your bottom hand up quite quickly. Weight goes to the right, now to the left, and then see if you can get some height. All right, next one. Stick handling also doesn't just involve the stick, but it also involves our feet as well too, so handling the puck, puck handling. So we're gonna be kicking it as if we're doing a soccer dribble off our inside edges. The weight mostly is in the toes, and the toes are doing most of the kicking. If you ever lose it, then lose the puck, then use your stick, pull it back in between the feet. And again, a lot of it's about the weight transfer. If you're kicking with your right skate, then kick with your right, but place your weight on your left. Kick them together, then place your weight on your right, and then kick with your left so that you're not making this sound and sliding off your inside edges, but instead just giving it a bit of a tap, a bit of a tap. Last set of our kicking it off of our edges, we're gonna be doing a toe drag, sliding your hand down and tucking the puck, so letting go of it. Kick it off your inside edge. Do the same thing again, slide your hand down, kick it up off of your left. So you can do just toe drags up and down the ice in motion or stationary like this. And then you can also pull it out to the outside, one-handed on the backhand side, and kick it off your outside edge. When you kick it off your outside edge, most important thing is that you actually turn your toes in so that you can kick it forwards. If you didn't do that, you'd be kicking it to the side, and if you're ever skating in motion, it would almost be to the side of you. You always want to be able to kick it ahead of you, especially as you're skating forwards. So turn that toe in. Again, if I'm kicking with my right skate, my weight comes to my left, and then I can more or less just kick it just off my edge. Really smoothly. can do the same thing again on the forehand side. Slide your hands together, tuck the puck, and then kick it. I bring my feet together and then kick it out to the outside. Just a nice, light, gentle. All right, so another one that we could do between the legs is instead of pulling it from the forehand side and actually tucking it off the forehand side, you can do the exact same thing, but now pull it off the backhand side. So this is actually one of my favorite ones to do. Pull it to the backhand side, and then off the backhand, you can kick it between the legs. Put it into your back pocket, place it to the backhand side, tuck the puck, let it go, and then meet it on the other side.